My wife is always at the computer, so I snooped and. Hi everyone, welcome back to another Reddit cheating story. Before we start, please hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell so you won't miss another cheating story goes live. 17-year marriage, I'm, M, 39, she's, F, 48. We have a teenage daughter. I know we're a bit older than most people on here, but I just needed some help and everyone on here gives such straight answers. Sorry for the long story, but I'm also typing to feel a bit better. I feel we've had a good relationship with the same problems as every couple. Money, kids, etc. I'd say it's typical. Around 6 years ago, my wife had what I consider to be an emotional affair that would have gone further. There was a person she worked with who she saw every day, and I think it started out typical, just friends with like interests, and then an emotional connection occurred. He wasn't getting the attention from his wife, she wasn't getting the attention from her husband, me. She would get on the computer, I would watch TV, and that was our night. I would go to work in the morning, she would go to work in the morning. What she was doing on the PC was imming her friend at work. I suspected it and even asked her what she was doing, but she would minimize it and say nothing. Eventually the curiosity got the best of me and I had the chat client save logs. Of course what I found just rocked me. They were chatting like they were planning for the first time to meet up in his garage because she was on her period so she could perform oral sex. She told him that she would tell me she was going out with friends. He asked intimate details about her body, asking if she was shaved, stuff like that. I was devastated. Just devastated. I saved the log, printed it out, went downstairs and asked her what she was doing, and again she said nothing. I then presented her with the papers and she said, "Oh, that's just bullshit." Kind of denying that any of it was true, that it was all a game. Eventually I got out of her that they had accidentally kissed a couple times at her work and that was it and the rest of it was just 99% bullshit. I asked her, "How do you accidentally kiss someone, you fall into his face twice?" I had to leave, I went for a drive, I was shaking and weeping. I went to my office at work and called my boss to tell him that I might be off for a few days and he understood why. After the call I had the most awful physical feeling of love. My heart hurt. It felt physically like a vacuum had pulled it into itself. Just empty. It made me cower to the ground. It hurt so much. I came back that night and kissed my daughter on the head and laid down in the same bed as my wife, she was already asleep. Eventually, as it turned out, she said I wasn't fulfilling her emotionally and giving her the attention she needed, so she had replaced me with him. She said the chat log was bullshit and nothing was going to happen. I cannot believe that to this day. I still dwell on what could have happened. I called the other guy and told him if he did not stay away from my wife there would be consequences to pay. I had chat and text logs, he had a family. Don't be stupid. I then wrote her a letter that I shared with her over lunch. It was an ultimatum. She was to cut off all relationships with this person, friendly or not, and if anything like this happened again it would be no questions asked, I am gone and forgotten. I had already accepted the fact I was going to stay with her because of many reasons, I still loved her, and I thought I would eventually be able to trust her again. Problem is I have never gotten there. She has never admitted it was an affair. When I suggested it was an emotional affair, she's dismissive of it. She feels it was a mistake, but she feels like I was so emotionally distant she didn't have anyone to go to. And I will admit that at the time I was. It was work, video games, eating, Ambien, and sleep. Oh, and let's add to that I'm impotent and need a plethora of drugs to get going, so sexually, I am not a dynamo in bed. We tend to have sex once a month. I sometimes think if she gets the sex of her life from me she'd be much happier, but that's just movie plot thinking. And before you think she's sneaking out and getting it on with other people, she's not. Let's just leave it at that. We live in a very small town, everyone knows everyone. Her sex drive diminished greatly after the baby, and sure I'd love to have it pick up dramatically. But first things first. Anyway, here it is 6 years later and I'm going to hit 40, and it comes back. I generally get stuck on it every once in a while, I see the words from the chat burning in my eyes and my heart shrivels a bit. But now 40 makes you look back, and it's hard. I don't know what to say. I've suggested counseling but the local counselors are a little too churchy. All I think I want her to do is to really apologize to me and admit that she had an affair. Is that selfish? Greedy? Is that blackmail? Will that be enough for me? To this day she says to stop worrying about it. She's not going anywhere. I'm never getting rid of her. She wouldn't let me go. She loves me. She texts me that she loves me when she's at work and it's such a great pick-me-up. I want to forgive her and move beyond, I really do, but it's so hard. Here are the top comments from our community. m/53, married 24 years, with 3 kids, oldest 21. You aren't older than everyone on Reddit. There are others like me, lurking in the corners. There are a lot of aspects here for you to work through. I cannot, and will not, tell you what to feel. Reddit is going to tell you things along the usual lines, focusing on the wrongness of the cheating. Well, Reddit isn't wrong, but one size doesn't fit all and isn't likely to be the only thing operating here. So think about the following points as well, in which I think you will find positives. First of all, yes, she emotionally cheated, and yes, you are correct, she would have done more than just kiss if you hadn't caught her. And yes, she didn't deal with it very well, by simply minimizing and denying the last lame defense of the truly caught. And yes, a good chunk of the feelings you have resurrected stem from the fact that you didn't get to fully deal with the issue when it happened because of the way the two of you dealt with it, internally without good counseling. You, for instance, never got the certainty she was being fully forthcoming. But the context here is one of those from which relationships encountering cheating regularly recover. Cheaters bear responsibility for their actions, whatever the reason, but cheating stems from a wide range of circumstances, and some are much more repairable than others. Yours was one of the latter. She didn't cheat because she was so insecure that she could not stand stability, or because of a deep-seated character flaw. She cheated in reaction to a growing emotional distance in the marriage. If the two of you had gone to counseling, the sessions would have focused on re-establishment of that emotional connection, amongst other things. Whatever the disclosure would have been then, and the process, ask yourself whether you've both re-established better emotional connectedness and involvement. Not just her telling you she loves you, but your actual involvement with her, and her with you. If you have, then you have both addressed a big part of the circumstances leading to the original incidents, whatever her acceptance of responsibility. Secondly, you will feel, and many will tell you, that the cause of your current issues is because she never accepted responsibility, and she was never fully forthright. This isn't so much wrong as insufficiently profound. While the events would not have been forgotten by you, you originally resolved your feelings in some fashion at the time. The way it was resolved isn't fully the cause here. You'd likely still be reliving it all now, I suspect, even if you'd gone to counseling, she'd fessed up and you got all the reassurance and satisfaction you wanted at the time. No, your feelings have resurged now for specific psychological reasons. You don't identify why clearly. I know you worry about the impotence, but you aren't clear on its timing, and if it has been the case throughout, it isn't the reason these feelings are coming back now. I think I know, though. Your daughter is growing up. I suspect that fact is changing the dynamic in the family, and whether or not she is actually dating, it will subtly change the psychological context for you. Her growing sexual and relationship maturity and currency is reminding your unconscious psyche of your own sexual and relationship status. And that bears indirectly on your relationship with your wife. You are opening old drawers to examine the past issue you had with her, trying to figure out how to put it back in a new drawer, driven by your new family circumstances. Old insecurities, and perhaps new ones, are being relived as you do this. What once worked for you no longer works, not because your relationship is being threatened or changed, indeed, I'll bet it is better since the events you are reliving, but because elements of your life are changing around you. The best option here is for you to go to counseling on your own, to talk it out. Once you've done that for a while, and you've figured out all your emotions and concerns, you can decide with your counselor whether raising it with her makes sense. Please go. I know it's hard, and I know you are probably not comfortable with it, but you'll feel better. Just tell her you are going for the impotence, and leave it at that for now, so that you don't disinter the issue too early. Hope this helps. All the best. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell for any future cheating stories.